sign that she would always be there to look after them. After many years of waiting, God fulfilled his promise to send a man, a savior, a Messiah, to earth to go among the people and teach everybody his peaceful and loving ways. This would be God's greatest gift to all people.
To prepare the world for this man, God asked different men and women to prophesy or foretell that Jesus was coming. These people were called the prophets. This is what they said.
Now, when God was ready to give Jesus to the world, he chose a holy young woman named Mary to be his mother. Mary lived in the little village of Nazareth and was engaged to be married to a humble carpenter named Joseph. One day, when Mary was alone, God sent Angel Gabriel to give her the news.
About to give birth.
But when they arrived, the city was already very crowded with other people who had come back to be registered, and all of the inns were full. But Joseph sought shelter at several inns anyway, in the hope that someone might spare a room for Mary.
Me and my wife have traveled a very long way. Do you have any room for it?
Sorry, I have to move.
But Joseph sought shelter at several inns anyway, in the hope that someone might spare a room for Mary.
Me and my wife have traveled a very long way. Do you have any room that you're in?
I'm sorry, we do not have any room.
And so it went at every inn. One innkeeper looked at Mary, who was greatly child, and felt sorry for her.
Please, me and my wife have come a very long way. Do you have your room?
I have no room in my inn, but you may stay in the back.
The stable was for animals, for the donkeys, cows, and sheep that people had brought with them. But Mary and Joseph were grateful for any shelter they could get that night in the little town of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
night that Jesus was born, the angel Gabriel suddenly appeared above them in the sky.
Come as people have come all the